Hey, what's up? This is David from Disturbed. You're watching Fuse On Demand. Get it when you want it.
Power! Power! It's always been abused! Worked at poverty taxes! Lost oppressive roles! Power! Power! Just might never change! No answers will come from a bloodthirsty wave!
God, the first time I was turned into hardcore was through my older brother. We were all into the same music. Like, we all loved heavy metal at the time, like the classics, you know, like Deep Purple, Rainbow, Black Sabbath. But we were always looking for something more. We got into Iron Maiden, and we got into Judas Priest, and we got into Motorhead. My older brother started branching off into punk, and we got into Plasmatics, Sex Pistols, and then we found out there's a vibrant scene in New York. My older brother would tell me about these bands. And as we went to high school, I met our drummer Armand. And he turned me on to Agnostic Front and the New York scene, and that was amazing. My parents used to think we'd go to every matinee, every Sunday, but then they would be, where are you guys going? Every day you'd jump on that train around 2 o'clock, you head down into the city, we'd go to these shows. They didn't mind us going to the shows because they were cheap, $5, oh, it's a matinee, what can it be? But then we'd come home with bruises and scratches, and they'd be like, did you get into a fight? No, we were dancing, and they would just think it was the weirdest thing. The first time my dad ever saw a videotape was of an old Agnostic Front show from New Jersey, and I had gotten it from a friend of mine. And I was watching it, and he walked in and goes, what is this, a gang fight set to music? And I had to sit there and explain, look, they're not hurting. They're not really hurting each other. He thought it was funny.
Let's celebrate that we don't give up. Let's celebrate that we don't care.
People didn't really have a place in society, and that might sound a little bit like a common thing to say today, but it was true. Sort of outcasts, a lot of homeless kids, kids that didn't have good family structures, you know, like fall out of the 70s.
Just didn't fit in.
We were like the first people to come in that sort of had like family units. Yeah, family structure, right?
I remember the first time I went to CBGB's, I was so scared to go across that street, to go across Bowery. I was just like shaking, like, look at these people, they look so scary. Walked in there, it was the coolest place ever. I didn't care. Back then, there was no set style for hardcore. You didn't have to have tattoos, you didn't have to do this. You could, or you could look totally different, you know? It was amazing.
Yeah, nobody discriminated against us. I was like a little kid from Queens coming in. I thought all these big, tough, tattooed guys were gonna kill me. They loved me. They were so nice to me, because I came being myself, which was great, because back in school and all that, you were like ostracized for not fitting in. Here, it was a home. Yeah, it was great.
The first official Sick of It All show was actually booked by Craig. Craig was in two bands at the time, Youth of Today and Straight Ahead. And we were just putzing around practicing. You know, the other guys in Sick of It All was me, my brother Pete, who's still in the band, and we had a different bass player at the time and a drummer. And Craig was like, you guys ready to play a show? And we were so scared. We never wanted it. We were like, oh, we're not ready,
So I put special guests instead of their name because they were like, I don't know. I was like, come on, you can do it, come on.
We sucked. We were horrible, but we were smart. There was a band from New York called Cause for Alarm who had just recently broken up. We covered one of their songs. The audience kind of liked our original stuff. We ended with that cover, the place went crazy. So
that was August 14th, I think, of 86. Is that right?
Something like that.
Yeah, I think that was it.
Yeah. At the
Right Track Inn
in Freeport, Long Island.
Yep. I think the club's there, but they definitely don't do punk shows anymore.
It's karaoke night now.
Yeah.